key aspects are twofolds. One is stickiness to the content from a consumer's perspective, and of course then there is how do you capture it, what is the success. Traditional ways of looking at it is of course the views, whether it is likable, whether it is shareable, whether people are talking about it, is it led by PR or does it lead to PR. Those are the valuations we ascertain saying that a content is great or not. I think there has to be a way or a process or a method where you're able to go beyond these, because I still think they're very, very niche at the moment. I think most of the content marketing is led by what is the objective of that campaign. If the campaign objective is brand, then of course then there is the resonance of the brand. How is the brand stickiness in the mind of the consumer? What is the brand saying? What is the proposition the brand is putting out there? That's one piece. The second piece is when the content is entertainment and brand is laden in the back. That is when you are entertaining a consumer, you are educating them, you are entertaining them, and you are also leaving some method or the other for them to be able to resonate with what you said. So there are two different objectives depending on brands to brands. Most of the brands today still are stuck to the first piece, where it is about their brand and how you stitch that brand in a story. I'm hoping that this piece will move to the latter part, where the brands are able to tell a story, and there are more brands who are out there saying a story with just a brand messaging in the back. And I don't mean by back, by just advertising, by just a banner or whatever, but very, very in-depth storytelling, which is brand proposition and that of the story. You know, it's really, really strange. I've been in the business of television, films, launching OTT platforms, branded content agencies. I have seen across my 17 years, last 5 years, we have moved, so it's again in two parts. For content creators, it's a great time. Once upon a time, you had these many channels or places to go and get that, sell that content or tell that story. Today, with almost everybody and anybody producing content, those avenues have opened because the consumer has become smart. There is so much out there. There's so much of opportunity which is there. They're saying in 2022, the mobile users, the handset will go multiple folds. I think it's a great time for everybody, for the consumer to be able to watch. Today there is no longer the day where entertainment only means watching television or watching a film. It's basically watching anything and everything you like across genres on the go. So I think in times to come, but I still feel that slightly it is a bubble. I foresee this going on for another 3 years, between 18 months to 3 years, and that is when the point will come where one will be able to ascertain the fact that those who are there to stay and those who are basically going to fold, because content making is not a easy proposition. It's a very expensive proposition. Has to be able to, whether it is a producer or those who are buying it, you have to be able to monetize it at some point in time. Is the consumer willing to pay at this point in time? The answer is yes and no. Many say yes, many say no. So different stages. I personally believe very few set of consumers, but if they like it, they buy it. And I think we are already seeing successes with the like of Amazon, Netflix, Balaji, Alt Balaji, Hotstar, etc. So yeah, it's a great time, and I'm glad I'm a part of this time, and I hope that we all will be able to entertain our consumers in whichever screen we are looking at. Once upon a time, everything was gut and gumption. You would look at research numbers, but they were very, very less. You would do focus groups, extrapolated to larger part of universe. Today, digitally, you're almost listening to everything. You exactly know what your consumer wants, what he or she is looking for, what are they doing. So to give you an example of how technology helps. So for example, looking at keywords, what is the consumer searching? So you know what he or she is searching and is not getting. So you can obviously, that's an insight. It's also an opportunity for you to be able to create or source, either or, as per your business objective. I think Netflix has done this greatly. In fact, they are the ones who are spending billions of dollars in doing this. Artificial intelligence. So today, Netflix actually throws content to you depending on the thumbnails you've seen previously. Because the research says that only two seconds is what you make time to understand whether you're going to watch a piece of content or not. And that's when the algorithm will throw otherwise. In fact, we are spending a lot of money, we are investing a lot on AI to be able to understand. So if you come on Play and if you are watching content with us, the app will actually talk to you. So when it talks to you, to me, to anybody else, will be a one-on-one experience. I think that's a great space to be in, to be able to know and to be able to cater. And that is when you form a relationship with your consumer, and then he or she will stay.